Welcome, dear students. Myself, Sheetal Miss from Adarsh Education Society. Welcome you all for the video lecture of your subject English. Today we are going to learn a new poem from unit number 1, the fourth topic, All the World's a Stage by William Shakespeare. William Shakespeare, one of the greatest name in English literature. Every individual who is a fan of literature knows about him. There will be absolutely no one who doesn't know about William Shakespeare. He was not only a great poet, but also a great actor and a wonderful playwright. He is the one who has brought us some beautiful, fine scripts like Romeo and Juliet and Hamlet, which are very, very famous. Only to name a few. The list is endless. During his lifetime, he has written more than 154 sonnets. Today, the poem what we are going to learn, All the World's a Stage, is one of his immensely popular works. It became very popular right at the time when it was introduced to the readers. Let's start with the poem. All the World's a Stage by William Shakespeare. Well, to tell you that this poem was earlier not a poem, but actually it's a monologue from one of his great play, As You Like It. And this monologue is said by one of the actor, Jax, in the play in Act 2 of Scene 7. As the speech begins, seven different stages of man's life are all that which comes to our mind. The words of this particular monologue are so well written, so well beautifully written, that we can actually imagine that a movie is going in front of us just when we read that whole monologue. So today we are going to learn this masterpiece of William Shakespeare, All the World's a Stage, where now Shakespeare has described this beautiful poem by dividing man's life from birth till death into seven ages. Now these seven ages are the stages which man passes through his lifetime. The first stage is of that of an infant. The next is of a school going boy, then the lover, then the soldier, the justice, the senior citizen, and last comes the second childhood, that is the old age. In this poem, Shakespeare has compared life to a stage. And he has used different words to beautify the poem in a very wonderful way. He has taken this concept from medieval philosophy, which shows glimpses of several different groups of the seven stages of men. Now look at the first few lines of the poem. The poem begins, the monologue begins with the line, All the World's a Stage, where the poet has compared the world to a stage, and all the men and women merely players. The poet says, the whole world is a stage, and all the men and women are just actors on this stage. They have their exits and their entrances. Here, exit and entrance means every player in this world, every actor in this world takes the entry on the stage at their birth. And then they play many parts in their lifetime. And after the part is over, after the role is over, they have to take their exit, that is death. And here the poet describes his act as seven ages. So beautifully written Okay, the metaphor used in the first two lines, all the world's a stage and all the men and women merely players. The world is compared to a stage and the people in this world are compared to players. Players means actors on stage. Merely means just. We are nothing more than actors. We are here to play our part. And then when our part ends, we have to take our exit. At first, the infant is the first stage of man's life. And what is the role of the infant? Mewling and puking in the nurse's arms. The infant, the small baby, has the role to cry in the nurse's arms. Nurse is the one who takes care of the baby, the one who takes care of the infant. That is the mother, the father, all the caretakers. So the first role played by the men on this particular stage of life is of that of an infant. He cries, mewling means crying, and he pukes. Pukes means vomiting. Whatever unwanted food is given to him, whatever he doesn't want, he vomits in the nurse's arm, in the arms of the one who takes care of him. So look at this summary, which describes the first stage of man's life. Here the child is a helpless creature. Helpless because he cannot do anything on his own. He cries in the arms of his nurse for one reason or the other. He cries and then he vomits. Look at the second and the third stage which man plays on this stage. That of a schoolboy. See the lines here? Then the whining schoolboy with his satchel and shining morning face, creeping like a snail, unwilling to school. This is the second stage what man plays in this life, that of a schoolboy. Whining schoolboy. Whining means complaining. He doesn't want to go to the school. He's carrying his bag on his shoulders. But he doesn't want to go to the school. He grumbles, he complains, he cries. He's going very slow. He's creeping like a snail. So this schoolboy is compared here to go as slow like a snail. So simile is used over here. His face is bright, smiling, shining, innocent, you can say. But at the same time, he is unwilling to go to school. He is not interested to go to school. But then too, he has to play his part. The third stage is that of a lover who is sighing like a furnace with a woeful ballad made to his mistress' eyebrow. Here the third stage or the third role which man plays on this particular stage is of a lover. And the only person he sees in front of his eyes or the only one whom he is attracted the most is his lover. And there is absolutely no other person he loves or he is caring about at this particular stage. And he does everything to comfort his lover. At times, he sighs like a furnace. He is singing a woeful ballad. Woeful means sad. Ballad means song. Made to his mistress' eyebrow. Mistress here is the lover of the person. And for the beauty of the lover, he sings songs. At times, he sighs for... He is not able to express his feelings and emotions at this time. So, the feelings here of the lover are sometimes happiness, sometimes sorrow. And he keeps singing songs. Look at the summary of these lines. That is the second stage and the third stage. The second stage is of the school-going child. With the bag hanging from his shoulder. But he is creeping like a snail, very slow like a snail, because he doesn't want to go to school. And then comes the third stage of his life, a man who plays the part of a lover. He grows into a young man who is full of desires, ambitions and dreams. He becomes a very romantic young man. He falls in love and sighs like a furnace. He also starts writing sad poems, sings sad poems for his beloved. He cannot control his feelings at this particular stage. Then comes stage four. Stage four is that of a soldier. Then a soldier full of strange oaths and bearded like a pard, jealous in honor, sudden and quick in quarrel, seeking the bubble reputation, even in cannon's mouth. Now here, this is the fourth role which man plays on this stage, that is in this world. And that role is the role of a soldier, or you can say a fighter, where he takes all the promises, he takes all the vows, and he is strong as a pard. Pard is leopard over here. The strength, the courage at this particular age of man is like a leopard. He begins to take all the promises to do his best in life. He wants to achieve success at this stage of his life. And at times he becomes jealous of others' success because he himself wants to go ahead. He sometimes also quarrels, very quick to pick up quarrels and fights with others to maintain his dignity and to develop his reputation. Now, such a reputation which he is very keen to develop by becoming jealous of others or picking up quarrels, this reputation is compared to a bubble. Bubble means this reputation doesn't stay for a long time. It disappears. Same is the attitude of the soldier. The way he becomes angry, becomes very keen to pick up quarrels. This particular behavior of the soldier also is like a bubble. Here in this particular stage, he is ready to take up all the difficult challenges. He is ready to pick up all the risk of his life. Cannon's mouth. Even in cannon's mouth means he is ready to stand in front of all the difficult challenges of his life. But at the same time, as time passes and as he reaches to the next stage of his life, this particular behavior disappears like a bubble. Look at this particular summary. The fourth stage of man's life, where he becomes a soldier, a one who is very strong, not only physically but also mentally strong, and he has matured to learn how to behave in his life. But at the same time, he is so keen to get success in his life that he becomes jealous of others, ready to pick up quarrels for his honor and grace. But this particular behavior is also temporary and just like a bubble. And as he passes through this age and takes a step ahead, he becomes more mature. Then comes stage five. Stage five here is compared to a justice. In fair round belly, with good capon lined, with eyes severe and beard of formal cut, full of wise saws and modern instances. And so he plays his part. Now, in this particular stage, as he enters the stage where he turns into a wise man who knows what is good and what is bad, what is right to say, what he doesn't have to say. So, this particular stage is the stage when he has crossed the 45 years, that is, he is in the middle age of his life, where he has high status in society, but he does not remain as he was in the earlier stage. He does not pick up quarrel with others. He does not take hasty decisions. He tries hard to keep his success with him, but in a very matured manner. He enters into this stage and he is not greedy to achieve more and more in his life. He has become sober. So here it is compared to fair round belly. Now at this age, he doesn't care for his own self. He is so busy fulfilling all his responsibilities that he neglects his own health. And so he gains weight, he gains fat around his belly because he doesn't follow a healthy regime. He does not have good eating habits. His eyes have become severe. He has become more matured over here. And his beard of formal cut. His looks are very simple. He does not have any liking towards fashion now. But at the same time, he is full of wise saws. Saws means sayings, advices, and modern instances. He is ready to give examples, recent examples. And so in this particular age, that is the middle age, he plays his part very well. He knows how to deal with people. He knows how to act in a mature manner. Look at the summary of these lines. That is the fifth stage of man's life, where he is compared to a judge. The middle-aged man is compared to a judge as he becomes more matured and experienced in his thoughts. He cools down. He becomes very realistic. He knows that he has to deal with what is right, and he knows that he cannot commit mistake at this age. But at the same time, he becomes little careless about his own self. And here his belly becomes round. He eats unhealthy food, and his eyes become severe. He is he thinks a lot about his success and how to maintain his status in life. So this is the fifth age of man, the fifth role of man, that is the role of the middle age. The next age, that is the sixth age, shifts into the lean and slippered pantaloon with spectacles on nose and pouch on his side. His youthful hose, a well saved, a world too wide for his shrunk shank, and his big manly voice turning towards childish treble pipes. Now this sixth age shifts into the very thin and very lean person, that is the senior citizen, or you can say the elderly person who has crossed the age of 65 and is going on towards more. And this particular age, he's a retired person. So he has become very thin. Okay, he is wearing pantaloons, the loose pajamas. Now he has left wearing his formal clothes, which he used to wear during the time when he used to go to work. So he is wearing loose pajamas at home, his slippers, the shoes are kept away. He is having spectacles on nose. Now here his eyesight is becoming weak. And he is keeping a pouch on his side. Pouch over here refers to all the things what he requires during the daytime. He keeps nearby. Because at this time he has become physically weak to get up again and again to get his things. So he is at home all the time and he keeps his things ready. His medicines, his spectacles, whatever he needs, some books or whatever. And here there is a drastic change in not only in his health but also in his voice. When he was young, he had a loud manly voice. But now that particular voice has become like a childish treble. That means it's like a small children cries. We can hardly hear clearly what he speaks. His youthful hose, well saved, a world too wide. That means whatever the clothes, the hose over here means a close fitting covering for the legs. That means the pants. The tight pants which he used to wear during the time of his youth are now kept away. Saved. That means he now doesn't wear those formal clothes. He wears his casual pajamas in his house. For his shrunk has shank. That means he has physically become very weak. Look at the word shank. Shank means legs. Shrunk means it has become very weak. And then comes his manly voice. The youthful manly voice has now turned towards childish treble. Treble over here means very weak. It has become like small children, which cannot be clearly heard. Look at the summary of this line. The sixth stage of the life where man is growing old. He looks quite ridiculous in his movements. because his movements are now restricted. He cannot physically move from one place to another with ease. He is wearing glasses as the eyesight has also turned weak. His shoes have become wide for his feet. Here, as I said, that he has become very weak now. He is not a young man more. His voice has also suffered a change, which has become very shrill. Treble pipes means which has become very shrill. So this is the sixth stage in the life of man, the stage of the elderly person, the very old person. The seventh stage is the last scene of this drama of life. The last scene of all that ends this strange eventful history is second childishness and mere oblivion. Now this particular last scene is of the second childhood, which is nearing towards the exit of one's role in this stage of life. This stage ends our strange, eventful history. What do you mean by strange? Strange means which was full of different type of situations, ups and downs, joys and sorrows. Eventful history, the story of men, which was full of different events and incidents. So the last stage brings the end of all which man did during his lifetime, right from the first stage of that of an infant. This stage is also called as second childhood. This stage is also called as second childhood, which is mere oblivion. What do you mean by mere? Just. Oblivion means a state where one is unaware of what is happening around in his surroundings. So this is the stage where he becomes very old and he is in a state of, you can say, unconsciousness, in which he is unaware of what is happening around him. So this is when he grows up to more than 75-80 years old. And look at the last line of the poem, the concluding line. Here in this stage of second childhood, which is more than about 75 years, 80 years. Sans teeth, sans eyes, sans taste, and sans everything. Now, sans word is repeated over here. Sans means without. Now, if you compare the first stage, which was of an infant, to the last stage of second childhood, we see a lot of similarities. The infant was without teeth. The infant did not have proper eyesight, did not know the taste of different food. He was completely dependent on the caretaker. Similarly, when man comes to this age of his life, that is the seventh stage of his life, at that time he has lost his teeth. His eyesight has become very, very poor, very, very weak. He does not have any liking for more food now. He doesn't eat more. And at the end, he sans everything. That means he is without all likes or all desires. He is just now tired and he wishes that now, he knows now that this is the end of my role. I have to take my exit now. And with this, the last stage of man, that is the seventh stage, the final stage, where a man turns to a child again. He forgets everything. And this stage, he knows now he has to be ready to leave this world. In this poem, Shakespeare has the seven stages of man's life very beautifully described. And he has described this with a feeling or with a touch of satire and cynicism. That means the reality of life is being portrayed over here, that you know, you come on this particular stage, you take birth on this particular world just to play some roles. You are nothing more, just a small part in this world, but at the same time you have to play your part throughout your lifetime. And this wonderful poem tells us how man has entered into this life at birth, played his different roles very fantastically, and then he has reached to a stage where he has to bid farewell to the stage and has to leave this world. Now, so beautifully written, this particular monologue, where man's life or the stage is written with such wonderful words, concrete images about how man has to play his role in this life. Right from the infant, then the schoolboy, then the lover and the soldier and the adulthood, then the middle-aged man, the second childhood. All the words are wonderfully written. And this makes this particular monologue, this poem, one of the greatest classics of Shakespeare. Now, what message do we get from this poem? If you look at the image here, the seven ages of men, this poem, All the World's Age, is also known as Seven Ages of Men, where all the seven ages are portrayed so wonderfully, where men and women are players in this drama of life. And we are not here to live forever. We have a particular lifespan, we have a particular role to play, and then we have to leave it. And man passes through these seven phases of life in accordance to this age. Now, if we talk about man's age, some people are quite fortunate that they are able to play all these parts in their lifetime. Some aren't. For some, the role ends at a particular stage, even at the stage of an infant or a schoolboy, or that of a lover or a soldier. Now, infant, then the schoolboy. Schoolboy is the child. Okay, then comes the youth, the soldier, the wise man, that is a matured man who has attained adulthood, who is the middle-aged man. And then last comes the second childhood. Some people are quite fortunate to get a lifespan of playing all the roles, all these different roles in life, whereas some don't get a chance. This particular poem gives us the message that however short life is, we are here to play a particular role. We have to play our part. We are the players. We are the actors on this stage of life. The whole world is a stage, and all the men and women are merely players. So we, as players, as actors, we have to perform all our roles in our life in accordance to our age. So students, I hope you all have understood this poem. We shall meet again with the next video lecture. Till then, thank you.